What? Three things I want to talk about briefly about the sunrise surprise. The first one is the obstacles were gone. Number two, the opposition was gone. And number three was the observation that Jesus was gone. Somebody say amen. The first thing we want to talk about, the obstacles was gone. The Bible says in verse 3 that the women were going to the sepulcher to anoint Jesus. And they had a conversation while they were walking. And the conversation was, who is going to roll away the stone? I don't know about you. That would have been a big thing in my mind, realizing that we're going to see where Jesus was laid, and it was already prophesied. We saw what they did, but we questioned amongst us three was, who is going to roll away the stone? Has anybody ever been in a situation that you had some stones in your life, and you couldn't fix it, you couldn't pray it out, you couldn't work it out, but you had to rely on God some kind of way to fix things? Somebody say amen. I don't know about you, but I can imagine the women having a conversation in my mind, their mind, who will roll away the stone. And listen, God has already, point number one, God has already, I'm going to say it again, point number one, God has already gone before them. Yes. They kind of fixed it out and worked it out and planned it out. God has already gone before them to roll the stone away. I want to speak to somebody this morning. You might have stones in your life that's trying to hinder you or stop you. God has already gone before you to make the path clear for your sake. Somebody say amen. You might not see it now in April, May, and June, but God has already in November and December and has moved some things out the way just so you can have easy access.
Yeah.
Somebody say amen. Somebody say he's already done it. Isaiah 45:2 says, I will go before thee and make thee the crooked path straight. You think you're trying to plan it out now because things look hard. Well, listen, God is going to surprise you come November and December with a crazy way. Somebody say amen. Somebody say, won't he do it? Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Won't he surprise you? Unexpected surprise. Somebody say amen. So now we realize that the stone is gone. And I want to encourage you, no matter what it is, God has already rolled. God has already gone before you. Somebody say hallelujah. Number two, it says about the opposition is gone. You have to understand over in St. Matthew's, the 27th chapter, I think it is, his Matthew's version was that there were some guards set outside the tomb. But you got to remember that the Pharisees had went to Pilate and said, Pilate, why don't you put some guards outside the tomb? Because I know those disciples will go there and try to take the body. So Pilate, let them put some guards outside the tomb. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Well, the women there, they see the stone is gone. But then they get there and see the guards are there. People will try to stop you from going where God wants you to go.
Right.
People, somebody opposition will stop you from doing the things that God wants you to do. But guess what? Just like God had already moved the stone, he had already moved the opposition out the way.
Yeah.
Well, the Bible says that there's an angel that came. God had sent an angel down.
Yeah.
And the angel had frightened the guards so much that they were in deadness. What are you saying to me now? Well, God is going to surprise some people that have set you up for failure, that have tried to stop you from doing the will of God. God is going to make them in deadness, which means God kept them back. God froze them in their tracks. They couldn't attack you. They couldn't do anything. Their only job was to stop anybody from going in the tomb.
That's right.
And the angel came and surprised them when they couldn't move. Well, guess what? I'm not talking about no angels with no wings, but God will dispatch angels at your job. God will dispatch angels at the bank. God will dispatch angels in your family that will stop the naysayer, that will stop the critic, that will stop anybody that's trying to oppose you from doing the will of God. Somebody say amen. Because guess what? Everybody don't want you to serve God.
That's right.
Everybody don't want you to go to church.
Amen.
Some people try to oppose before you, to move the obstacles, and to move the opposing. Sometimes you don't even know who's trying to stop you from doing the will of God. But I heard the Bible say, I will let nothing separate me from the love of God. Somebody say amen. And the last thing I want to talk about, I go to my seat. So God has already moved the obstacles. He's already moved the opposers that they couldn't do anything. And he already sent an angel to hold everybody trying to stop us. He held them back. And the last thing was the observation that Jesus is God.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. That's a son all by itself.
Yeah.
He didn't move the stone. He didn't stop the soldiers that we got access. Now we in the group looking for Jesus. Observation, I gotta look for. I wanna be an eyewitness that Jesus is no longer there. The man you're looking for is already gone.
Yeah.
Listen, I wanna tell somebody, some people thought you'd stay in that situation. That situation had you bound, tied up. Put stones in front of you and put people of guard you that you wouldn't get out. But the devil is alive.
Yeah.
Late in the midnight hour, God will surprise you and turn it around.
Yeah.
Somebody say hallelujah.
Yeah.
They walked in. The angel told them. He's not here. And they had to look for themselves.
Yeah.
It ain't nothing like the eyewitness. Any eyewitnesses know that God can work miracles. Know that God is a healer. Know that God is a way maker. Know that God is a bridge over troubled water. Won't he know it? Ain't nothing like a surprise. Ain't nothing like a surprise healing. It ain't all y'all ain't paying nothing. It ain't nothing like getting money from unexpected places. Surprise! It ain't nothing like God turning things around. What the devil meant for evil, God will turn around for your favor. Surprise! Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
They went in there, looked for him. Jesus is God. He is risen. I want to encourage somebody this morning. You can experience the sunrise surprise. And you're like, God is already going to go before us in some situations that we don't see now in April. But come November, December, God has made the crooked path straight. And listen, for anybody that meets you hard, for anybody that dug a ditch for you, God is going to send you an angel. That's going to hold back everybody that opposed you from doing the will of the Lord.
Yeah.
And listen, the one thing about it, the angels, listen, the guards saw the women go in. What are you saying now? It ain't nothing like people that meet you harm, see you be blessed.
Yeah.
The Bible says he'll prepare a table before you in the presence of the anybody trying to stop you. God prepare a table. And they got to see you get blessed.
Yeah.
Then finally, observation that Jesus is God. That he rose.
Yeah.
He rose early in the morning for my sins, for your sins.
Yeah. Yeah.
That we had to have a way out. We had every kind of obstacle in our way. People that opposed us. But the blood of Jesus still has power. I like that song that said, living, he loved me. Dying, he saved me. Buried, he carried my sins away. Rising, he justified. Free me forevermore. One day, he's coming back. Oh, what a glorious day. Is anybody looking for that day he's coming back? Is anybody looking for that day? Oh, but we thank God for the blood of Jesus. We thank God for the, come on, we thank God for the blood. Because the blood still works. The blood still has power. The covering power, redeeming power, the healing power, the saving power. There is a fountain filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's name. A sinner plunge beneath that blood and lose all guilt and shame. Listen, whoever you are, wherever you are right now, the blood can be applied over your life, above your situation, and you can get happy about the sunrise surprise. Again, it don't have to be 5:30 or 6 o'clock in the morning. You can experience a surprise right now by closing one chapter in your life and opening up another chapter to make the Lord ahead of your life. Listen, I want to encourage you. Easter, Resurrection Sunday, is greater than a bunny. It's greater than buying clothes.
Amen.
Yeah, we might not be able to do a lot of things we typically do, but that's what we focus more on, the cross. And what Jesus went through just for me, he did it for me, and I thank God he did it for me. That one day when I was lost, Jesus died upon the cross, and I know it was the blood for me. The sunrise, the prize. I can't somebody want you in your car at home, just open up your mouth and give God a hallelujah praise. Come on, just open up your mouth and give God a hallelujah praise. That one day he changed my situation, he turned it up, he surprised me. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Bow your head. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, God, we thank you for this time with you. Oh God, we thank you for the sunrise surprise that you were no longer there. The grave couldn't hold you, death couldn't hold you, the stone couldn't hold you, the soldiers couldn't hold you, but you got up. That we can get up. Hey God, because you got up, we can overcome. We are more than conquerors through Christ Jesus, God. Oh God, we thank you that you're going to roll away the stones in our lives. We thank you that you're going to hold back the opposition in our lives by the road that is trying to oppose us from doing your will. And God, when we get there, God, oh God, we thank you, God. You're going to allow us to rise above circumstances and situations, lay that weight upon the Lord. We're going to renew that strength, and we're going to mount up. Hey God, and we're going to see things differently, God. Because it's a sunrise surprise. And right now we say thank you, Lord. Oh, we say thank you, Lord. We give thanks to your name, Jesus. We give thanks to what you've already done, God. We give thanks to what you're going to do in November and December, God. How you're going to make a crooked path straight. How you're going to go before us, God, and move things out of our way. Oh, God, the people who look for us in that situation we thought they was trapped in. We're going to be out, and we got the victory, God. And for that alone, we say, thank you, Lord. On this resurrection Sunday, I will rise again, God. I will rise again. Thank you, Jesus. We say amen. Come on, put your hands together. Come on, put your hands together. Give God glory. Come on, put your hands together. Give him glory. Sunrise surprise. Let God surprise you with a miracle. Let God surprise you with a way out. Let God surprise you. Hallelujah. Listen, church. Listen. Listen, God. As we get ready to close, oh my God, I want to challenge each and every one of you to get an offering either by PayPal or Cash App. Cash App is $COTLG Baltimore. Oh my God, on this resurrection Sunday. Listen, I need the economy to rise.
Yeah.
Y'all ain't saying nothing. Yeah. I said the other last Sunday that in this time that God is taking us through, you got to remember when the children of Israel were in bondage. Listen to this. They multiplied more in bondage. How did that happen? God surprised them.
All right.
But listen, they gave God something to work with. I'm challenging myself because God told me to do it. I'm giving $100 every Sunday until God lifts us where we can come back in the house of God together one more time. I challenge 20 people listening to me out there to see the $100 gift. Even if you can't on this Sunday, if you can't, whatever you give, it's going to rise.
Yeah.
It's going to rise. The circumstances, your favor in our lives is going to rise. But you got to give God something to work with. If you're tired, oh my God, listen. The Bible says this. Bring me all, not a tenth, all your tithes and offering into my house that he has room to bless you. It said, then he's actually prove me. Uh-oh, here we go. Prove me. It might not come out tomorrow, but come November, December, when he moved it away out in April, God will manifest himself. Somebody say amen. I challenge everybody, if you don't have a church home, type into the Church of the Living God here in Baltimore, Maryland, where it is fertile ground. Come on, bow your heads as we pray over this offering. Father God, we thank you for this time of giving. We thank you for our jobs.
Yes,
Lord. We thank you, Lord, more so than we thank you for sources of income, God. Oh, God, right now in this season of plague and famine, God, we said, my people shall be satisfied. Lord. God, you make a way out of no way for somebody. Somebody that's not working, God, you dispatch one of your angels to them right now in the name of Jesus Christ, God. For those that are working, Lord, cover us in the name, cover us with your blood, God. For those tithers, for those that are giving in this ministry, God, you manifest. let our finances not run out. Give us more, hey, what we're going through. Give us more, what we're going through. For people on their life, God, you will overflow blessings in Jesus' name. Come on, in Jesus' name. Put your hands together as you can at COTLG-Baltimore. A million payments at the 400 Weaver Ball.
Yes, God.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes, God.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, God.
Every shackle
broke.